Australia. We're pretty busy, but we'd love to show you around.
Yeah, it's a bit of a big deal for him.
Oh,
I'll just go and check for you with him to make sure he's on his way.
Okay, fantastic, thank you.
महाराज जी ए कैटरीना राउंडट्री है
हाँ जी
ते बैंडा का
हाँ जी
हेलो इट्स लवली टू मीट यू
हाँ जी दे
सचिकाल
सचिकाल इस नाइचे
खूबसूरत लड़की हाँ जी
ही सेज दैट यू आर अ वेरी अट्रैक्टिव लेडी लुकिंग वेरी नाइस टुडे
थैंक यू वेरी मच
ले खाइए ते देखिए बढ़िया थी सोनिया खूबसूरत जाए थे हाँ जी दिखा लिए
Shall we show you some of the ornaments that he carries
yeah.
with himself everywhere he goes to?
Thank you.
ये साड़ी बड़ी पुरानी की pebbles हाँ जी
These stones are from some very sacred healing people that he carries with himself to cure himself of any illnesses
Hanji, Hanji.
that
Hanji.
Maharaja has. Maybe you should try.
I'm getting the flu. Tell Maharaja, I'm getting the flu at night.
Hanji. This is...
Jakam, minu vi lagga si kal parson da, te jadon de main phad ke hath vich.
What do you do with them?
Hanji.
Ki kar rahe ho ae din naal?
Changa assi dikha laange ho na. Hanji, tusi
phad
ke te akha meed ke. Oh, garmi thalle ho
Look in the window and you need to hold this in your hands and think of a very positive thought. And if you can think of a positive thought for around 10 seconds with your eyes shut, please.
I'm thinking about my
name. कुछ लगा तुसी फील कीता गर्मी आई थल्ले उतार तक
did you feel the heat from
I
the bottom
I feel much better
come in
हाँ जी
holding the positive thought in my mind
हाँ जी
it did help me made me smile
कहती है कि जिन्हों दिमाग में बच्चे ने गाल बैठी है ना
हाँ जी बड़ी पुरानी चीज हाँ जी
दूसरी चीज़ दिखाइए इन्होंने ये देख के जो की है
ये तो बड़ी पुरानी चीज है ये साडे बड़े बुजुर्गों की चीज हाँ जी
यादगारी है
यादगारी जी हाँ जी
दीज आर हिज प्राइज पोजेशंस दीज आर सेक्रेट एशेस दैट महाराज carries with himself wherever he travels.
Hanji.
He travels with them. He's been given the responsibility of hanging on and protecting these ashes for his generations to come.
Hanji.
So
Hanji.
He is betrothed with this responsibility to have it within his place wherever he goes. And due to that, he pays his respects to the ashes
right.
at every Hanji. One time, any time he's taken upon a new project.
How old are the ashes?
Kinne chir diyan?
800 saal di ji.
More than 800 years.
Really?
Hanji.
And oh, has he ever accidentally dropped it?
Oh.
आपने कहीं भी कितने भी जाके ना ये हो जाए चीजें डग गया हैं या कितने कितने?
नहीं जी नहीं नहीं ये तो ऐसी है नहीं.
No, that's
और that would be
sacrilege.
Really?
No, that's not acceptable.
Excuse me, sir. Bad, bad. Phone call for Maharaj, Mr. Goldberg, Paramount.
VSO थोड़ा ना फोन कॉल हैगा ट्रंक कॉल
वी ऐसे तो टेलीफोन
हाँ जी
अच्छा जी मैं जानता माफ करना मैंने 2 मिनट टेलीफोन तो ले आऊँ तो पैसे ऐसे ही आंदे हाँ जी ओके
एक्सक्यूज जस्ट फॉर अ टेलीफोन कॉल
थैंक यू
इधर जी मार जा जी सिर्फ इधर के ढंग ले
I actually feel much better. What are we going to be stiff as boards?
Yeah.
Right. He's very much into protocol and. Oh. No. Don't worry. No. You can put them back in because I really would rather he didn't know.
Mr. Goldberg will talk for ages. Don't worry about it.
It's probably actually the table.
You have to get those under the chair, Trains.
Oh, no. You can't say anything. You can't say anything. Oh, we'll get some things.
I can't believe it.
Will Ben destroy Katrina's chance of cracking the Indian market? Back after the break.
I realise that this may be amusing, but I'm seriously possibly going to lose my job.
Story so far. Getaway reporter Katrina Rowntree thinks she's on the verge of breaking into one of the world's largest television markets, India. But she has to make a good impression on a rich Maharaja. Meanwhile, her fellow reporter and our accomplice, Ben Dark, has managed to scatter the Maharaja's precious stones, smash a priceless urn, and spill ancestral ashes everywhere. Not bad for a day's work, but it ain't over yet.
Oh, well, we're screwed. We are screwed. Don't start getting huffy. I didn't.
It's okay. If you wouldn't mind, though, if we could just. I really, really would rather him not know.
Why? Look the here. Bars? No. I'll go into Melbourne. I'll go into Melbourne and I'll buy one of these. That's it. He won't even know. What's funny? He's not going to know if we just have advance like that.
Mr. Dark, look, I'm sorry. I realise that this may be amusing, but I'm seriously possibly going to lose my job over this. I can't afford that. This is my livelihood. It's my career. Please.
I didn't... Look, I know. Just understand it's just like... We're just having trouble believing that it can happen to us.
He's going to be back shortly.
Yeah, okay. Here, I'll give you a hand. What do you reckon yours is? Get that cleaned out. Just clean that out of the teapot.
I think if you could just...
Just throw some of those ashes in there. If he blows up, then we can say it's the same
pot. I'll take that. For the moment, I would really appreciate it if you didn't say anything, and I assure you.
Now, all you have to do, look. Was your phone call good?
Did you have a good look around and see all these different things that he has?
Very interesting. Thank you.
Yes. Before we talk on any serious matters today, we'll just do a tea drinking ceremony that we usually hold beforehand. So maybe we can get Nigel to seated and comfortable. Maharaji. He's been here. Can I chair with you? Yes, I am.
6 months have
passed. 6 months since he's been here. He's interested in buying the ride, so maybe looking at it on to make the Indian public appreciate this show as much as Maharaji himself is. To the future. Thank you. Thank you. Cha, bhai.
Both of you.
We are bringing the special gifts we have for our guests today so that Maharaji can present them with it.
Thank you. Maharaj.
Oh,
Tina Rowntree. Welcome to Surprise Surprise!
I just want
wanted to leave the building without you straight away. But then I just thought, this is one of those shows. This is, and then I just thought, oh my God, but what if it isn't? What if this is the real thing? And I kept thinking, who's Mr. Goldberg? Should I know who Mr. Goldberg is on the phone? My heart was just racing so fast. The Stones. I really got upset about the Stones. The Stones were broken.
Well, you're a world traveler. You would have known those Stones were so sacred.
Exactly. But the 800-year-old vase, that freaked me out as well. Because I was like, because Ben said, I'll just go down the road and buy another one. I'll buy another 800-year-old vase.
He said, oh, wow, what a house.
I'm just thinking of all the things I've said to people. I've told so many people I'm meeting a Maharaja. People called my boss's secretary and I said, now, tell me about the Maharaja. And she's like, what do you mean? What are you talking about the Maharaja?
I knew that you'd be doing research, right? And I thought in the car, now, this is how we shake his hand and this is what we call him.
The very diplomatic Katrina Rowntree. Coming up next, the singer they call Australia's sweetheart, Julie Anthony. London's West End and Australian icon Julie Anthony. Our accomplice is her manager and nervous husband Eddie Natt. Now Julie's at Channel 9's Melbourne studios where she will sing and do an interview with Richard Wilkins for the Today Show. Now Julie thinks she'll be live across the nation. They are in a commercial break at the moment and setting everything up, you will hear the voice of the Today Show host in Sydney, Steve Liebman. He seems to be having a little audio trouble.
Richard and Julie, can you hear me properly?
Yes, Stevie. Dear.
Yes, Stevie.
How's your tennis going?
Can someone just turn up my volume a bit? I'm having having trouble hearing them in my earpiece.
You play?
Oh, I do, yes.
I'm still having a bit of trouble hearing Richard in the earpiece. I still can't hear him properly.
Someone turn up Mr. Liebman's ear.
Are you right to close the show, Richard? Don't come back to me, please. I'm out of here.
What are we doing? We'll chat.
Do the song.
We'll do it as normal.
And if we've got the problem with TCM, Julie, we might get you to come across again.
That's right. We can.
Knitting with Julie.
We can pat it out till midday.
Here we go. Remember, Julie thinks she'll be live to air.
Well, as promised, joining us in the studio, Australia's first lady of song, Ms. Julie Anthony, AM. OBE, the star of stage, screen, everything else, including the Sydney Olympics, where she sung the national anthem, Our Song, to the world and stirred the hearts of the nation. And it's always a great pleasure to see you. Lovely to have you in the studio.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm
good
terrific.
Morning, all.
I mean, it must be nice going through life and the career with a man you can love, trust, share, share all the
magic.
Great times with.
It's magic. How lucky can you be?
You've got to sing now.
All right, if you say so.
You go
all
over
right.
there.
Okay.
And Julie Anthony, the gal from Galga, is going to be singing. This truly is a beautiful song. Carly Simon's song. The song is Coming Around Again from the album Never Stop Believing. Live around Australia, it's Julie Anthony.
Baby sneezes, mommy wheezes, daddy wheezes in. So romantic, but so bewildering.
coming around again.
Performing in the studio. Julie, come back and join us. That was fantastic.
I'm back.
I think we had a little studio glitch, little audio glitch here in the studio.
We must have, because they've handed me one of these.
I think we're having all sorts of...
Oh, look, live to air. Isn't this fun?
You can't beat that. Hey, listen,
I love it.
That is such a beautiful song.
It's a great song.
Carly Simon.
She's a wonderful writer. I love the way she writes. It's just about everyday stuff and that sort of a song. I think I chose it because you can relate to it. You know, when you're a mother and you're trying to do everything you want. Well, basically, I like to choose lyrically, you know, because as a singer, that's what you're doing. You're interpreting a lyric, basically. I like to do that. So that's the first criteria. After that, if somebody else says, the producer, then I've got a kind of favour. Why can't I do that? There's pretty good reasons, otherwise, you know, I kind of stick them down.
Do people come to you and say, you know, this would be a good song for you? Do you always have experts who think this would be a good song?
Oh, yes.
Who's that guy?
Surprise, surprise!
What is this? Oh, my Lord.
Hey, gotcha.
I used to like you.
This one. You don't need this anymore.
Oh, how could you? It's too early in the morning.
Winner of the surprise, surprise extra is Eddie Knapp. So he's supposed to be an extra on your show, but I don't like you anymore.
Guess what? He is an extra.
Yes, I know. I keep going through, if you know, herd of elephants had come through, I keep going.
Oh, man, this was just terrifying. I've been so... And I bumped into Judy. We were both checking into the hotel last night, and I saw her there, and I saw her. I wanted to run away.
See, you've got a conscience. Oh, at least you've got a conscience.
The unstoppable and unflappable Julie Anthony. Coming up next, Larry Emder meets a new breed of superhero.
I am the Invisible Man. I am the Invisible Man. Whip it.
Whip it. It's a great place to meet and greet people. It's also a great location for this next setup. Now, our victim today is Mr. Game Show himself, Larry Emder, and our accomplice, well, he's Larry's business manager, Brian Scher. The Albion has a reputation for attracting interesting and beautiful people, but today we're going to introduce Larry to a whole different species altogether.
You've got to think about coming up.
Cheers, mate.
Indeed.
Oh, yeah, look, you know, if I do this deal, you know, I'm just going to have to pass on it, mate. Yeah, so when you get back to Sydney...
G'day, how are you all today? How are you, mate?
Good to see you.
Nice to see you.
Good to see you.
Do you mind if I take the orders for you, mate?
No, go ahead.
Congrats.
Good to see you, mate.
There he is.
How are you?
G'day, mate.
It'll be me a few years' time, mate. I'll be doing it.
You like that? Yeah, that's the way. I am the Invisible Man. You cannot see me. You do not know what's going on.
I hope he's not coming over here.
It's moving.
Oh, my God.
Oh.
Through the lunch, I think.
It's making my wine move.
Can I have
bring some money, isn't it?
I'd rather father make him go.
You can see me now, but you can't see me enough.
I'm just going to go there briefcase. I'll actually, where's Carl? I'll be a second.
Oh,
yeah, just watch this.
Larry. Yeah. Carl, how are
nice
you?
Nice to meet you. I just popped out to the car.
Oh, great. I'm finally glad to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
I've heard some interesting things.
No, I don't believe all of that stuff that he tells you, whatever you think.
Okay. Yeah, so do you have a good flight down?
Yes, thanks for that. Yeah.
Ah, not a problem, not a problem.
Yeah, sure.
Hello? Well, it affects the deal tremendously if it's locked up in customs. I mean, what am I going to do about it? I was supposed to be here 3 days ago.
I am invisible again. You cannot see me. I am invisible.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's going to close it. I need to know by... What, it was supposed to be here by 12:30, wasn't it?
Excuse me.
Can you get back to me as soon as possible on this? Because if I don't really get this thing going, I need to get this done. Yeah. Yes, so. Okay.
What's going on?
Yeah.
Rick
Hall?
Oh.
Thanks.
Brian! Hey, how are you doing?
Good.
Hi,
good seeing you. Thanks for getting this organized today. Sorry about that. I just got a couple of really stupid things happening at the moment.
What's the story with the car, man?
Oh, he's the local fruitcake. You didn't realize that California is not the only place of the lands of fruits and nuts, you know?
Yeah,
I was listening up to the American accent, but it wasn't there. It was a good hat, though. I think there's a whole fashion thing in there. I think we can work on that.
Well, maybe that, you know, since we're talking about the game show, maybe you could wear that hat. What do you reckon?
To invite him.
Like the Madonna thing. Two of them.
Hold on.
Busier than you, man.
Busy man.
Okay, great. Yeah, all right. I can't hear you, though. Hello?
Can you just say hello? Can you speak up?
Hey, I'm going to have to check this outside, okay? Can you watch my stuff for me?
Yeah.
I'll be back
sure.
in a few minutes.
Okay, sure.
Yeah, thanks. Okay.
I have that weirdo doesn't kind of hear around.
Oh, he just came. He just stood behind him while he was on the phone.
He stood behind Carl? Doing what?
Just listening to his phone call.
No way. Where's the fucking bathroom? I'm busting. I'll be 1 sec.
Oh. Just leave me here, mate.
There you go.
I've got 15 seconds to tell you this. I'm a secret agent working for ASIO.
Is everything all right or we're in danger?
Chap over there is with me.
Yeah.
If you can just stay with me for a minute, just stick with me, just work with me for 1 second. Unfortunately, this chap. Major player. I'm sorry, sir, but I've got it. It's okay. Don't worry. I'm with ASIO.
Okay. Is that okay?
That's okay. You just... Don't you... It's okay. You've got to help me.
Is there more than two of you? Because I'm scared.
Just...
I am the invisible man. I am the invisible man.
Whip it. Good.
Oh, what's that? What's the story?
Apparently he's a spy. That guy. Don't be scared. I'm armed. We've got people watching.
What are you talking about?
Sorry about that, gentlemen, but got it done anyway. Looked like you've seen a ghost.
No.
Okay. Just what do you say?
Go on.
Just tell.
What's going on?
Tell them what you told me.
What did I tell you?
I don't know, you said everything's under control, like the guy was a spy or something.
No, no, you, see these, this guy over here, right?
I'm Dudu's guardian, and he doesn't mean any harm. He just comes in, and the patrons all day and just tag him. And he thinks he's, you know, an astronaut or something. I don't know what was he saying to her.
Yeah, look, he's a car thief, international spy, and accused me of being Alan Bond.
Look, I take no responsibility for his parents. I look after him. You can see he's harmless. He thinks he's Superman. He's trying to fly out.
So anyway, this guy walks in with a pot on his head.
I think I've heard that joke.
Now either Jay's going to jump out or he's going to tell me something really strange.
Well, thanks for nothing.
Now I get that's my payment in the briefcase.
Well, you know, when he actually went to take photographs of it and you were such a good boy and said, no, it's not yours. It's not yours.
I tried.
Mother, I tried. Ladies and gentlemen, Larry Emder.
Thank you.
Back with more Surprise Surprise Madness after the break. Let's take a look at what we got in store for you next week on Surprise Surprise.
We know music industry executives are generally middle-aged, but pop sensation S2S find out that they can be hard of hearing as well.
That's okay. That's okay.
Is swimming champion Scott Miller completely insane? Why would you let anyone talk you into a straitjacket? Least of all, Nicole Stevenson. Feisty stage star Amanda Muggleton faces a new drama on a building site.
It's got to be louder. I've got to hear it. That's it.
And we amaze an AFL all-time great, Ron Barassi.
Totally makes all the clothing totally disappear.
That's coming up next week. Now, because of the overwhelming number of requests from you, the viewers, to see your favourite gags, we've decided to run the best of Surprise Surprise in the next couple of weeks.
Jog your memory. Check out these magic moments.
The Warriors have won with 20.
On behalf of my wife and I, I'd like to thank you all for coming.
Hey. Are you James Morrison?
Yes, I am.
There you go, and I'll just grab your pulse if that's okay.
The gold medal was picked up earlier in the week in the team's event.
He hit the tail fast time.
Totally eliminates anything that's made of rock.
Congratulations, that's you. Wow.
High level radiation, but it turns out all it is a low megahertz type of stuff.
Beams of energy.
No, it wasn't her dog. No. It's my dog.
Welcome to
Now, in order for you to vote for your favourite gag from Series 1 and 2, get in touch with us online at 9msn.com.au/TV shows. Vote now. Until then, I will see you next week on Surprise Surprise.
So if we can get something in the back of the camera van.
Yep.
Just pick up the briefcase so I can see, you know, and then put it around this side.